reporting the handwriters as his words in Christ, to make it the fourth Sunday in ordinary time, year B. The theme is Familiar Bread for Them. Our master's title for today is Father Mark Anthony Sermon, OMI. Brothers and sisters, we often see God in the spectacular, the sun rises and sets every day. And then we devise providential care, but we prepare to look for God in the dancing sun. We pray for miracles of healing, all the while that God heals us of our body and spiritual ailments through the sacraments and the help of loving people. Let us all rise and together sing the infamous hymn.
Thank you. Heart of peace and
of the day of fire. I pray to whom I am sending you. But you shall say to them, thus says the Lord God, and whenever they read or cease, for they are a rebellious house, they shall know that the prophet has been among them. The Lord of the Lord.
And thanks be to God.
This was our song.
Aleluya.
accompanied the least disciples. When the Sabbath came, he began to teach in the temple, and many who heard him were astonished. They said, Where did this man get all this? What kind of wisdom has been given him? What mighty things are wrought by his hands? Is he not the carpenter, the son of Aaron, and the brother of James, and Joseph and Judas and Simon? And are not the sisters here with us? And they took them as a man. Jesus said to them, a prophet is not without honor except in his native place, and among his own kin, and in his own house. So he was not able to perform any mighty deed there, apart from curing abusing people by laying his hands on them. He was amazed at their lack of faith. And dear friends, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Sisters and brothers, today is Sunday, and for most of us, it will be a day of rest. But more often than that, it is quite the opposite. I'm not saying that today is a day of unrest, but resting might be the last thing we can ever do today. Sunday can be called the busiest day of the week. We bring our children over to church for catechism class, and then to whatever class we can take, swimming, music, and many others. Some of us will be doing their groceries, shopping. Others will visit their friends. But no matter what we need to do and where we need to go, at the end of the day, we need to go back to where we started from. And that is home. Home. Going home may seem to be like quite a comforting thought. As what we always say, there is no place like home. But that depends on how we say it. It can have two different meanings. I want to share with you a story to show the different meaning of what I have said. There is no place like home. There is a story about a man who was stopped by the police around 1 o'clock in the morning. And he was asked where he was going at such time, 1 o'clock in the morning. Well, the man replied saying, I am on my way to a lecture about alcohol abuse and the effects it has on the human body, as well as smoking and staying late at night. Then the police officer asked, really? And who is giving that lecture at this time? And where will it be held? Then the man replied, the lecture will be given by my wife. And it will be held at home. So no matter what, and whatever the time would be, and no matter who is there, and whether it is a comforting feeling or not, we will still have to go. In today's gospel passage, We heard of Jesus going back to his hometown with his disciples. Having been away for a while, it would have been a good fit to be back. To see his mother, the passing friends, and to be back to familiar surroundings. Things at the hometown may have not changed much, but something has changed. Jesus had changed. From the time he left, and now that he had come back, he had certainly changed. This has been one. Because with the coming of the Sabbath, Jesus began to teach in the synagogue. And that astonished the people of his hometown. Obviously, that was something that he did not do before he left. He wondered at his wisdom and his miracles. He traced up his family, especially his family connections. And finally, they came to a conclusion. They would not accept him. However, Jesus handled his own rejection from his townmates by taking it humbly. Instead of raising his voice or getting angry with anyone there, he did his ministry by curing a few sick people. Sisters and brothers, if one of us experience rejection from our children, from our loved ones, and other people, in spite of our efforts to share the faith and love with them, it is some comfort to know that this was the experience of Jesus too. And the last line of the Gospel passage tells us the reaction of Jesus. He was amazed by the people's lack of faith. Their minds were closed, even though they admitted that there was wisdom in Jesus. I tell you, home is not all the time home sweet home. One day, the wife was busy packing her clothes, and the husband asked her, "Where are you going?" And the wife answered, "I'm moving to my mother's house." After that, the husband also started packing the clothes. And the wife asked, "Now, where are you going?" And the husband quickly replied, "I'm also moving to my mother." Then the wife said, "And what about the kids?" The husband answered, "Well, I guess if you are moving to your mother, and I'm also moving to my mother, they should move to their mother." Sisters and brothers, the reality is that many homes are not as healthy as we might want to see them. Many fathers have feelings and hate among members because they cannot agree with and accept each other. Sometimes there are disturbing issues in the families and we don't feel comfortable about that, and we would rather not talk about it. The same is true with Jesus. When the God in the second of his visions have disturbed his visionary souls, please make them not to upset them, to upset them. But as a result, Jesus was able to further serve his fellow mates because they did not upset them. Dear friends in Christ, it is really sad when we allow ourselves today to be blinded by prejudices and discriminations. When we discriminate or exclude people from our lives, we think that we are victorious in guarding ourselves from these unwanted persons. But the fact is that we prevent ourselves from experiencing what good they can contribute to our lives. Let us be careful. Let us be careful. Is that the one? Because we might be rejecting the people God sent to bring us this message. This message of hope and this message of love. So let us try our best not to reject others because of our prejudices or biases. Instead, let us pray for an open, humble, and welcoming heart, so that we will be ready for God's gift of salvation. Amen.
Please all rise.
I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the Holy Begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, who dwelt down from true God, begotten and made with the Son of the Father, through him all things were made.
I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the
promised paradise. We pray.
For he has called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so the angels, and our angels, and thrones, and demons, and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we say the name of your glory, as without end, we are praying. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more given thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink of it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
privilege that the Lord of mercy will be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
please summarize.
And let us pray. Grant, we pray, Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we regain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be to them for wise announcement and mass collections. First, we will have confession next Sunday. For details, please refer to the notice. And last Monday, our car is critically held operation. We continue to pray for the careful recovery. Thank you, Father, for being with us and wishing you all a blessed Sunday.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
All events and pray for God's blessing. Look, Lord, in the prayers of your family and grant them the assistance in our poor, so that strengthened by the help of the need, they may persevere in confessing your name. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass in offer hope is glorify the Lord by your mind.
Thanks be to God.
Nandito yung aking phone. Ito ako sa ano. Nasa taas kasi yung ano namin, yung simbahan. Nasa taas yung church mismo.
Hindi, lumaki. Ang dami pa ng bago.
Hindi, yung iba kaya itsura niyan, ha?
Thank you.
Square. Did you see the back?
Ang galing siguro sa anong
dyan. Iba pa pe. Bago to.
Yes, mommy.
This was, I was looking at something. Pinalitan yung upo.
Ano pangalan ba?
Yes! Pangalan yan, pe. Malaki. Ito kasi yung upo talaga. Hindi dito, te. Dito ka muna sa ano mo, sa bitin mong kalaban. Sa yung bitin mo. Wala ba sa ano? Meron yan. More. Walang more? Meron yan. Yung sa gallery ka pumunta. Sa gallery, gallery. Balik ka sa gallery. Baka mo siya sa gallery. Baka sa gallery. Punta ka sa gallery mo. Yung gallery mo yung lagayan ng mga ano. Baka sa ng gallery. Yung mga lagayan mo. Ang photos and videos.
Bakit wala sa TV? Saan yung ano ko?